And for weeks, Russia also has insisted it had the pandemic under control. Now it's nearing 100,000 cases and 1,000 deaths. Russia's prime minister says predicting an end date for the country's restrictions is impossible, as startling new images showing the dramatic strain on Russia's healthcare system are emerging. Senior international correspondent Matthew Chance has more for us on this. Matthew, the numbers don't add up, given what we know about the mortality rate for this virus. And now new images suggest Russia is struggling to keep up with the infection like so many other countries around the world. But what are you learning on this?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of very disturbing figures that have come out in the past 24 hours, and the likelihood is those figures are going to increase substantially. But there's a whole raft of sort of reports emerging, for instance, about particular hospitals in Russia that are being locked down, with both the patients and the staff inside all displaying symptoms of COVID-19. And I think this is important. There are actual, in a country where, you know, criticism and dissent to the official line is quite rare, we're seeing health workers post desperate messages online, sort of showing how the difficulties are that they're facing in everyday life.
For weeks, Russia insisted the pandemic there was under control. But these startling images from a hospital in the south of the country show just how overstretched its health service has become. This cold, tiny room was a laundry storage cupboard, according to the narrator. Now it's a makeshift ward for five coughing women. No room for social distancing here. And these aren't even the hospital's patients. They're medical staff, the narrator says, who've fallen ill with symptoms of the virus and with nowhere else to be treated. We can't confirm they have COVID-19, but a local government official says the women were later moved to a fully equipped ward and several hospital employees were disciplined. Still, it's a grim picture of the toll this coronavirus is taking on Russia's health workers. This Russian doctor says she believes a large proportion of medical workers are already sick, and in current working conditions, she says, more infections are just a matter of time. Across Russia, the plight of essential medical staff has become a major concern. Moscow's main coronavirus hospital is reported to have suffered mass resignations of key workers. Like Natalia Lubimaya, who complains on social media of excessively long shifts, lasting days on end, lack of equipment, as well as food and salary shortfalls. The hospital denies it's losing staff, but even the Kremlin is now acknowledging acute shortages of personal protection equipment, or PPE, despite ramping up production.
In March, 3,000 protective suits for doctors were produced per day. By mid-May, it will be over 150,000. Yes, in comparison with what it was just recently, it is a lot. But in comparison with what is needed now, it is still not enough.
It's been just a few weeks since Russia was exporting assistance overseas to the US and especially Italy, where Russian doctors were shown working side by side with their European comrades. But at this hospital at home in St. Petersburg, Russia's second biggest city, ambulance drivers say they're waiting up to 10 hours outside just to deliver a single patient. The numbers, it seems, are already overwhelming, and Russia's peak, according to the Kremlin, is yet to come.
Well, we're expecting an update shortly on the latest casualty figures inside Russia. But in the meantime, President Putin has been preparing the ground in the country for the potential of more bad news, telling Russians they are about to face a new and grueling phase of this pandemic.